Ayer, Hostiles is a small movie, but it's also a very, very good one. Oh, what a pleasant surprise. Actually, it wasn't too big of a surprise, because I like the trailer quite a bit, but how often are we fooled by the trailer, right? But this movie actually delivered. And it's interesting, because just the other day, while I was reviewing Bright, I marveled at how David Ayer hasn't grown at all as a filmmaker over the years since his very first movie. He's still making the same movie, right? But I did like Bright, by the way. I want to make that clear, thanks to the clever concept and great acting. But here, you've got everything, including a filmmaker, Scott Cooper, who is definitely evolving. David Ayer often writes and directs. He didn't with Bright, but Scott Cooper is likewise a writer-director. And I wouldn't be surprised if he's taking a few notes from Ayer himself, because Hostiles plays like an 1890s version of Suicide Squad, complete with hate, violence, the law versus gangs, again, 1890s style, right? It definitely had that flavor, and even a blonde. And likewise, what a cast. Although here, an even better cast, because when they set out on their mission, I was like, you have no red shirts, who's gonna die? And the answer is, nobody's safe. Now what Cooper has here that separates him from Ayer in particular is a more sophisticated approach and how the quietest moments of his movie are often the best. For example, I don't want to give anything away because the movie's full of a lot of shocks and surprises, right? A lot of shock and awe. But there are two wonderful written and acted out conversations that are a delight to behold. And I think would impress, like, it's like what anyone, like it's an actor's dream or someone who's going to be in acting class. Like if you're looking for a scene from a current film, here's two. So Christian Bale and Stephen Lang have this amazing conversation at the beginning of the film with Lang playing Bale's superior officer, giving him the mission. And then, I don't want to give anything away, but there's another really great conversation between Bale and Jonathan Majors around the middle of the movie that blew me away. Majors? Wow, what a find. He is a new actor with a flurry of interesting upcoming small roles on the horizon. But hopefully he'll get his shot at bigger roles, because I was really, really impressed with his work here. He had the ability to command the screen without showboating. It's rare to see an actor come out of nowhere, particularly if you're like me and you cover if you cover entertainment for a living, and usually they'll make a bigger deal about new talent, right? So that's another reason they're not such a surprise. But you know, this is coming from I think it's the same distributor who released 47 Meters Down, right? Which actually did pretty nice box office numbers, but they just don't have the juice to appropriately market this movie, which is a real shame. But everyone in the movie does a really good job. It's an amazing cast. They do as good a job as you would expect, and it's the definition of an ensemble effort. But aside from Majors, it's Bale's picture, and he plays such a cool, complex man with great conviction. And of course, all the best westerns are about cool, complex men with great conviction. And like with Cooper's script, Bale's best moments are his smallest ones, like his quietest ones, like the childish, self-conscious way he tries to fix his hair whenever he takes his hat off. I loved Bale's character. Absolutely adored him. And the ending of the film, again, I don't want to give anything away, but I was amazed how it managed to be both a Hollywood ending but still real and earned at the same time. It didn't seem like a cheat. I could see it being accused of being a cheat, but you know, sometimes there's nothing wrong with a Hollywood ending that has shades of a Hollywood ending. I found it immensely satisfying. And I'm a big fan of realistic stories that show how the world really is and how the people in it really are. And this is that kind of movie. It will give you a lot to think about, to mull over, and you will be richer for it. Now, I don't think I can recommend you pay to see this on the big screen, unfortunately, even though it does feel very much like a movie, the American West in all its glory. But make a note of it, make sure you do not miss this movie when it does become available for streaming. I would actually categorize it as a don't miss. All right, so that's my review of Hostiles. I'd be very curious to hear your thoughts about the film down below. And as always, you can check out some more videos right now.